the Dominican Republic's public investment in education is only 1.2% of their gross domestic product. This graph shows the relationship between a country's gross domestic product per capita and its performance on the SERCE math test for third grade in 2006. Percentage of sixth graders with high achievement, level 4, in the SERCE reading test in 2006. Once again, you can see the Dominican Republic scores lower than any other Latin American country. Only 2% of children in the Dominican Republic will reach the highest level of reading.
Yo no quiero limpiar zapatos para ayudar a mi mamá.
The Dream Project is a nonprofit organization that provides quality education to children born into poverty in the rural areas of the Dominican Republic. We fulfill our mission by building schools, libraries, computer labs, securing books, school supplies, materials.
About 15 years ago, I went into the school that's over here, the public cabarete school, and I brought down 5 books in Spanish. To the director of the school, he's no longer there, but I brought the books in and I said, I have these books, would you have a need for them? And he said, wow, thank you so much, and he took them. And so a week later, I went back to see, you know, if the kids were enjoying them or should we bring more books. The books were gone. He had taken the books. The kids never saw the books. So that's when I realized, okay, I need to create some kind of safe haven for these books. We created a little library at this one school. By the time I sold my mountain bike company, we had built 3 libraries, and I knew there was a need for a larger movement. And I'm really, really proud to call myself the founder of this organization.
The summer camp is a 1-month program where Dream Project brings volunteers from around the world to the Dominican Republic to help train and assist local teachers, take kids on field trips, and teach classes. Over the next 4 weeks, these children will have daily classes, go on field trips, and be exposed to free education that they would not have access to any other way.
One of the first days that I was here during orientation, a little girl that lives right next door just came up and gave me this great big hug. I felt really special, and just that these children that have nothing and yet they are so happy and so loving and caring, and it's powerful.
Hi, my name is Claribel.
Hi, my name is
We also take the children to the airport, and for many of them, this is the first time they'll ever get on an escalator. One of the trips is just to the public library in Puerto Plata, just so the kids can see what a library is. One of the most powerful things that happened to me was actually at Pizza Hut, of all places. There was a little Haitian girl, and she had never had pizza before. And instead of eating her lunch, she insisted on boxing it up so she could take it home and share it with her 9 brothers and sisters.
My name is Lee, and I'm a volunteer for the Dream Project.
Sammy Peterson, I'm a volunteer for the Dream Project.
Madison Mills.
My name is Lee, and I'm a volunteer for the
Dream Project. AJ Rudin, I am currently a student at Northwestern University.
Brigham Young University in Provo, Utah.
Columbia University.
York University.
Brigham Young University.
McGill University.
The little kids coming in up and giving you a hug, or bringing you flowers in the morning and wanting you to wear them in your hair the whole day, or bringing you bracelets and bringing you little things like that.
Children here are a lot more energetic, definitely. They're perhaps slightly less well-behaved, but they're a lot more friendly with it. They're just a lot more affectionate.
Most of these kids have never been on a boat. Most of them don't know how to swim, and even though they live so close to the ocean, they've never had any experience on there.
In the mornings when I would be really tired and not, you know, necessarily super excited to start the school day, they would run up to me, give me a big hug, and bring me flowers, and that was, you know, just would turn my thought process around and make me excited to be there.
A lot of people say to me, you know, I heard you give these children free water all day. They're drinking free water. They're children. They shouldn't be saying thank you for human rights. This camp has to be free. Parents should not be expected to give anything for their children to have water and food and basic education.
Ahora vamos a ver las cosas que nos puede ayudar a no tener presión, como una cosa positivamente, una cosa sana que nos puede ayudar.
No hay programa.
No haber programas de qué, de sexo.
No internet.
No ir, internet es importante, pero no mirar cosas malas. John, cosas sanas que podemos hacer. Jugar deporte, eso es muy importante.
Yo creo que es muy importante para los adolescentes que están creciendo y que pueden aprender de cómo protegerse, de no tener un embarazo a temprana edad. Como en este país no hay un control de que las chicas salen embarazadas muy temprano. Cuidarse y no estar todos los días en la playa, en la disco. Tener un control de su cuerpo para que puedan protegerse de la vida.
So I'm walking through all the classrooms today, and as I said, every single classroom, something else is going on, and I'm thinking to myself, how the hell are we holding all of this together? How are we doing this? Every single classroom is a huge project on its own. We have 48 field trips going out in the past 2 weeks that have already gone out. We have 70 foreign counselors and teachers that have come down for the summer to take part in this.
Each year the camp just kind of gets bigger and bigger. You know, more and more volunteers want to come down here and spend their vacation doing this camp. And you know, this year we had over 60 people. Every single day during summer camp, these children have a schedule that they stick to. It's math, it's reading, it's writing, it's science. They have access to some of the best educators, young educators in the United States, coming down here, partnering with their teachers that they work with throughout the year. They get much more individual attention. There's one-on-one academic tutoring. We also take kids to the landfill where they can see the impact of all of the trash that they're throwing away and how it's piling up and it's not going anywhere.
Well, this is styrofoam, and as I explained to the girls, it never ever disintegrates, never decomposes, so this is gonna stay for eternity. So we're trying to like make them realize that they should use other type of containers that are reusable and not making so much garbage.
Cabarete is the windsurfing and kitesurfing capital of the Caribbean. It's recognized as one of the wealthiest areas of the country. However, one out of every four households is still living in extreme poverty. That's less than $1 a day. The other 75% are living in poverty.
Well, the exact purpose for the adolescent camp is to try to inspire the kids about education, to have them create a desire in them to educate themselves. First and foremost, to graduate from eighth grade, and then of course to be able to graduate from high school, and hopefully be able to continue their education at a university level. And so that's the main focus, to be able to inspire them to, on their own during the school year, be able to get the education for themselves.
I didn't realize I would be getting into something so intense with so much work. But because it was so difficult and it was such a trying experience, it meant that much more, and I think I got that much more out of it. I guess my expectations were exceeded.
Parent Night gives these parents the opportunity to get some insight into what their kids are learning and come into the center and see the classrooms and look at pictures of their kids and see their art on the walls and talk to their teachers. And it's a chance for them to really get involved in their kids' education, which we think is tremendously important. Most of them, the parents themselves, can't read or write, so they really have no idea what their children are being exposed to.
The community in Cabarete is really involved with the Dream Project, and I think that's been really neat to see, that even though we work with just the children, we can see that it reaches further than just them.
Well, just the excitement in their eyes when they talk about these field trips that they're going on, and then when they come back and they've gone on this field trip and they tell me, you know, what they did, and it's amazing to see this light in their eyes when they're, you know, getting to have these experiences that they wouldn't normally have.
We also do before school programs, after school programs, community development through our community board, teacher training, raising awareness, training Dominican teachers and local community members and parents, and getting them involved in their children's education.
Each of the Dominican teachers and the foreign teachers have been paired. They've been given an email account, and the plan is that they will communicate throughout the year with each other. If you wait around for somebody else to get it done, it's not going to happen. If we keep waiting for the next generation, it's not going to happen. And the kids are getting old really fast. There's a lot of things that can be done, and there's a lot of help. There's a lot of us that were born with better lives. So the "we are the ones we've been waiting for" is also, in my opinion, is that's it. There's not a lot of time. And but when you start to realize that you are the only lifeline that these people have, and you think somebody else should be doing something, somebody else should be helping them, but you can't wait, and you can't wait for the somebody else, because nobody else is helping them.
I can't say how impressed I am with the energy and the dynamism of everybody associated with it. The children are delightful. Their engagement with learning and education and development is clear. The teachers are animated and enthusiastic, and I am just so pleased to have the opportunity to see it firsthand.
You know, the Dream Project is kind of what re-energizes me. It can be replicated in so many places where you get these kids young, provide them with values and opportunities, and, you know, the sky's the limit. You do so much for these kids, so again, congratulations.
Because I am one very, very excited fan of this entire undertaking, and I thank everybody involved. Thank you.
I would hope that there would be many other facilities like this that would be started in the Dominican Republic. So much impressed with everyone associated with this project. Thank you.
He always asks, you know, everything about my family and everything about where I live. And I've seen his house before, and I just think, like, I take everything for granted, but I'm so happy that I can help him and, you know, talk to him and get through everything, because I have a big family just like he does, but I'm a lot more fortunate, so.
Constantly meeting you all the time, it takes a lot of energy out of you. But it's a lot of fun, and by the time I get home at the end of the day, I'm ready for bed, and I'll be well rested and ready to go for the next day, so.
It is one of the most rewarding things I've ever done, but at the same time, it is very hard work. Being with these kids, listening to their problems, and constantly taking care of them, watching over them, has been, it's a tough task. And it was also tough for me to see where they live. You know, we come to school and everybody's having fun, everybody's, you know, just doing all these activities, but actually going to their houses and seeing what life is like outside of the Dream Project was very interesting and a very different experience from what I expected. And although the project is massive and there are lots of problems, when we're all working together and we're all doing our part, I can see that progress is being made and that these kids' lives, they're happy and that there is a change. Even if it's small, day by day, I can still see the change, and I didn't know that I would be able to see that before I came here. So it's great to be here. I'm loving it.
Action.